So, happy morning, my dear friends. Today, I would like to discuss an important concept with you, that is, five ways to improve your emotional intelligence. So, you must remember or well what is emotional intelligence or emotional quotient. And how to improve your EQ or your emotional intelligence. So we have lot of emotions. There are basically 8 types of emotions, such as happiness, sadness, anger, trust, and surprise, anticipation, disgust. They are all 8 types of basic emotions. They are joy or happiness, then trust, then anger, then anticipation, then disgust, then sadness, and then surprise. These 8 are the basic emotions. And this, how to know your emotions, how to control them, all these things come under emotional intelligence. So the ability to understand your emotions and others' emotions, and changing your behavior or your response with others as per the emotions of them, that the ability, you call it as emotional coefficient. The potential ability you have to understand your emotions and also the emotions of others and changing your behavior or your response or your way of talking with others after understanding their emotions is known as emotional coefficient or emotional intelligence. And your ability to interpret data, to think about the information, to store about the information in the brain, etc., it comes under intelligence coefficient. Intelligence coefficient you can get it by birth. So your intelligence is determined through the genes of your parents, but your emotional coefficient or your emotional intelligence is determined the way you behave with others, and it is acquired trait. It is a learned trait. It is not obtained by birth. So you are not born with a lot of IQ. You are not born with a lot of EQ. You may be born with a lot of IQ. So then emotional intelligence contains 5 components: self-awareness, motivation, self-regulation, empathy, and social network. These are the 5 aspects of the emotional intelligence. And then you can improve your emotional coefficient or emotional intelligence by improving your self-awareness. That means self-awareness is understanding your emotion and also others' emotions. So that you call comes under self-awareness. Once you are self-aware of your emotions, generally you are also having a lot of confidence. So a person who knows about himself very well, who can understand his emotions very well, and so they will be more self-confident, and their strengths and weaknesses also, and then improve that self-awareness, and then improve your self-regulation. It is the self-regulation, the ability to control your the ability to control your emotions that prevents your growth and leadership. That is called a self-regulation. The ability to control your emotions or inner feelings that will prevent your growth and leadership. That is called as self-regulation. So you can improve self-regulation. Suppose when the first and foremost thing is when you are emotionally disturbed, don't take decisions and don't communicate. So that is a self-regulation. Wait until your emotions come to the normal state. So that is self-regulation. Improve your motivation. Here motivation means a passion for your work and growth. So when you are strongly desired to work together, you will not think about positions. You will always work for a product. That comes under motivation. Improve your ability to show empathy. Very important. And as a team leader, you must understand the feelings, emotions, thoughts of others who are working in the team. And you must understand, if you were in that person's position, how you think. That is called as empathy. Then you can make a better decision. Then you can judge in a better way when you are thinking in other person angles, so that you can reduce the conflicts when you have an empathy. So empathy means understanding the other person's thought process, other person's thinking, other person's emotions, and thinking, if you were in that position, how you react, then you can take a better decision. Improve social skills. Man is a social animal. Unless and until you develop your social network, you cannot improve your business, and you cannot develop your total, overall, everybody, personality, which everybody accepts. So, keep the social relations in a good way. So, that is also important. So, my dear friends, so I told you what is emotional intelligence and emotional coefficient, and what are emotions. What are the basic emotions? By improving these five concepts such as self-awareness, self-regulation, your motivation, your ability to show sympathy, and developing your social skills, you will be a better leader, you will be the best leader, you will be the best team leader. Thank you.